Prepare to be amazed. Every video you have just witnessed was entirely generated by artificial intelligence. Using the cutting-edge Kling AI model, these stunning visuals were made from scratch in mere minutes, all at no cost. In this tutorial, I will guide you through the process of registering for Kling AI and harnessing its free capabilities to produce your own mind-blowing videos. So let's begin. Go to the klingai.com. Be careful with the URL. There are several fake sites. The link will be in the description of the video. Click sign in for free credits. And at this page, click sign up for free. Then it asks you to enter your email and password. Just set up. Then, as usual, verify it. Then click sign in. Then let's sign in. It may ask you to complete the security verification. It is like this. Let me show you. It may be different on your screen. So pay attention to that. And we are signed in into app. So you can look the existing videos to get the prompting ideas from them. However, I will use an LLM to generate a prompt for us. So how do we generate? You see there are AI images and AI videos. I am more focused on AI videos. Let's click the AI videos in the left panel. So it asks us to enter our prompt. I will use Hue to generate a prompt, and I am going to use Claude 3.5, which is the most advanced version. This is free to use on Poe. You can use it. You see, this is official and doesn't require subscription. Generate me a prompt that will describe an epic battle scene of dragons. Okay, let's try an hard prompt. Okay, let's use this prompt and see what we are going to get. So it allows you to describe with 2500 characters, which is a very long prompt. There is creativity and relevance, high performance, high quality. High quality is not available yet. Paid options are not available yet. It is only free to use right now. However, you are limited to generate several generations every day. Okay, there is frame ratios. You see, when I hover my mouse, it shows me the resolution. So this is HD resolution, this is also HD, and this is 960 to 960 as a square. So I'm going to use HD resolution, 1280 to 720. There are also camera movement options. You can select them. You see horizontal, vertical, zoom, pan, tilt, roll. So when we hover our mouse to the information, it says when camera control method is not specified, the model will intelligently match based on images or descriptions. We can also set a negative prompt to make it better. Let's also ask this to Claudia. So my second following question is, I am going to use this description on a text to video platform, optimize it, and also write me a negative prompt. Let's see what it is going to give us. Okay, you see it optimized it as like we are prompting like stable diffusion models. I don't know which one would work better, so I will test both of them. So this is the negative prompt. Okay, let's also use the negative prompt. You see it says that generate is 10 credits. When we go to the billing details, it says high performance video generation is 10 credits. And I have 66 credits that will expire within 24 hours. So you get every day 66 credits and you can generate 6 videos every day. Okay, let's generate. So you see it is quit to generate our video. Let's also generate with the second prompting. Okay, maybe I will open another page. Okay, this is the same video page. So I will use AI videos to generate a new one. Then I will use this new prompt from here. And I will use negative prompt one more time. Generate. Then let's generate another one. And this time I will not have negative prompt. I want to see its effect. So let's click AI videos. You see, when you open the same URL, it will show you the progress. Okay, this is our original prompt and let's generate. You see, there is also 10 seconds. However, high performance mode currently does not support 10 seconds videos. So we only get 5 seconds videos. Let's generate. And all 3 generations are visible here right now. Okay, let's just wait until they are completed. It is pretty fast when we consider that they are providing this for free to, I don't know, maybe hundreds, thousands of people, maybe millions of people. This model is the state of the art right now to generate text to video. It is just mind-blowing. All 3 generations are completed. Looks like Our prompt was very hard for the Kling AI. Perhaps it was very long. This is the first generation. This is the second generation, as you are seeing right now. And this was our prompt. So the prompting matters. Therefore, you see, this is the second video. The second video has no negative prompt. Perhaps the difference comes from negative prompt or the different seed, possibly different seed. And this is the third video. You see, this was the third prompting way that we did. Now I will make easier test with image to video option. These were text to video. It also supports initial image and animation. To do that, I will use this example image that I have prepared. Let's say, describe this image like a stable diffusion model. I will ask to the Claude 3.5 Sonnet. This is free to use. Okay, I will just use the description and see what we are going to get. All right. So let's go to the image to video. It says you are allowed to upload 10 megabytes with minimum dimensions. So let's click here. Let's select the image. There is also at end frames. It will be like beginning frame and ending frame, like in Tombcraft model. Maybe you have heard it. I haven't made a video for that, but hopefully I will make. So you see, this is our prompt. It is also optional. So I will also try without any prompt. And there is creativity and relevance as usual. The length, the camera movement, you can see the camera movement as well. So it is disabled for the image to video. We are not able to set camera movement. There is also negative prompt. I'm going to delete the negative prompt and generate. Then let's go to here and let's generate another version of this without any prompt. So we can compare what happens with and without any prompt. And we can generate one more time. So let's go to the image to video and let's select it again. So this time what I'm going to do is I will use prompt and I will pick the creativity maximum and let's see what we get. Okay, let's also delete the negative prompt and generate. So all three videos are getting generated right now. All right, all three videos are generated. Let's see the results. So this is the first generation result with the creativity maximum. You see, it is not very consistent, I can say that. This is the second video. You see, with the second video, we didn't provide any description and we made it creativity and relevance medium. And this is much more stable, as you are seeing right now, much more consistent. So it animated image based on the image itself without any prompt. And this is the third generation. For this one, we have used our previous prompt. Yes, this was inaccurate. So we used our inaccurate prompt for this one. So I am trying again with the new prompt that we have to fix the issue. However, this prompt is not accepted. You see, probably it has grassecute word in it. So this model may block some of the prompts you have. Let's try again. Okay, it still doesn't accept it. Let's see what other prompt may be preventing it. So let's see. Okay, and let's see what other things could be preventing it. Okay, let's try like this. Yes, this is accepted. This is a basic prompt. I am also going to test relevance maximum, and I am going to test relevance maximum without any prompt. So let's see all three generations results as well. All right, the new videos are also generated. So this was 100% relevance test. You see, it is very loyal to the original image, but the movement reduced and it is not that very great. And this is another test with relevance 100%, and we have a basic prompt. This looks like the best case so far. You see, it has animated the monster pretty accurately with pretty good stability. Let's download this and see with the media players. So the download is getting ready right now, and let's look another result while it's downloading. So in this case, we used a simple prompt and medium creativity and relevance, and this is also very good. So this model looks like working better with simple prompts rather than very complex prompts right now, as you are seeing right now. Even though they have let you 2500 characters length, when you write a very big prompt, it doesn't work very well. And here the video Let's see properties. Yes, it is looking pretty good. There is also another feature, which is AI images. And for AI images, I am going to try the prompt. So let's try this prompt. We can also upload reference image. There are also resolutions. You see all kind of resolutions. Let's try this. Number of images 4. So each image requires 0.2 credits. And we have 36 credits right now. So let's generate 9 images. It will use 1.8 credits. Also, I will use the other prompt that we had, which was here. Okay, let's go here and let's try this one. And let's see what we will get. I wonder that. So this will be that. Okay, since this is the new one, we need to click this. Oh, we have already. Okay, we can return back. So this will be the prompt. Let's use this resolution again and generate 9 more images. I wonder what we will get. Okay, these are the generations we get with a massive amphibious creature emerges from a rocky shoreline. And I can say that it is not very great. Yeah. So the AI image generation of this model is not that very great compared to the fine-tuned STXL models that we have. And it doesn't look very good as well. So these are the images that we have. It is decent. It is not bad. But it is not like super level like they have for text to video or image to video. And these are the other images that it has generated. So we can see them like this. Not very good. Yeah. So their image model is not very great, but their image to video and text to video model is just mind blowing. I hope you have enjoyed. Please leave a comment, like, subscribe, share. Hopefully see you in another video.